Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you can keep up with all my videos. Today I'm going to be talking about where I've been. I know I've been gone for a minute and I have a reason. Where I've been, let's talk about it. So I will be talking more about what I've been going through in another video. It's gonna be in more depth. So to keep it a little bit more private right now, I'm going to just show you where I've been. So where I've been. I've been on a journey, and so a lot has been happening this past 2018. I've been going through a lot of changes personally, and I couldn't be more blessed than what I am now. Honestly, like, in this day to day, it's so hard to, excuse the outside noise. Oh, I'm 29 years old and I'm going through some type of change. Let me tell you, it's been a roller coaster, and there's just been a lot of like hurt and pain that I've been going through. I've been going through a lot of depression and anxiety, and but lately I just kind of regrouped. So this past 6 months just have been just absolutely just horrible, and so I took a break. So basically, I know I keep rambling, but we'll get there. So I've been on this journey and this healing journey on finding out what makes me happy. It's hard doing it by yourself, but I think when you do it by yourself, you get more clarity. No one's talking in your ear. No one's telling you how to feel about a certain situation. What's been helping me with my anxiety and my depression is meditating in the morning, waking up super early, going to the gym, going to work, and being on top of things that I need to get done. Just kind of meditating and having one-on-one time with myself and God, and you know, doing like a devotion. I've been doing that. And I think forgiveness is so important, because a lot of people have done me wrong and I kind of was resentful towards them, and I wasn't fully happy with, you know, my surroundings, my living situation, my family, and you know, just the people that were constantly around me. I wasn't happy. So guess where I went, you guys? I went to Thailand, and I've never been out of the country before, and I was like, you know what? I need to do this for myself. And so it took me literally about a week to plan it. So this was like a last minute thing, spare of the moment. I was like, you know what? Me and a friend were like, you know what? We've just been kind of like on the same journey of finding ourselves, right? So I thought about it. I'm like, you know what? Let's go to the country. So we were talking about it, how we wanted to travel and stuff, and we just made it happen. So 1 week we're like, oh, we should, you know, go travel. And sure enough, we got our schedules together, and it was all girls. And it was the most like interesting experience that I've experienced. But we get on the plane, right? So this is what we did. I went to Thailand and I went to China. China was only for the day. Let me tell you, it was 1 day and it was chaotic. No one spoke English over there. I was like, can someone help? Someone? No, no one wanted help. So I was like, okay, I guess we're off on our own. So
we end up getting lost. Jesus.
And I went with my older sister and my niece. So that was kind of fun. So that was pretty interesting. We were in Thailand for the rest of the 6 days. So in those days, we rested, you know, we were at the resort. It was pretty nice. It was a Marriott resort. And we went canoeing, kayaking in the lagoons and caves and everything. And it was absolutely gorgeous. And we did some like Thai tradition where we like make like a cute little flower that it's a Thai tradition that they have yearly, and It was absolutely gorgeous. So we went back in there at midnight, no, around like 10 o'clock to light it up, and you make a wish and it's gorgeous, right? And then, so we make like this cute little flower thing, and I'll insert a clip here. And then we went to the Phi Phi Islands and other islands. We were island hopping. We went to go see monkeys. Oh my god, it was crazy. I didn't catch it on tape, but one of the monkeys like attacked the girl. That was kind of crazy. And they were wild monkeys, and they attacked this girl, and I was like, oh my god, like, you know. my favorite part of going to Thailand, I went for the elephants. You guys, the elephants, they were so loving. And where we went, they don't ride the elephants, and they don't use them for like, you know, they don't use them for like lifting or anything like that. They actually take care of the elephants. So that was pretty interesting. And honestly, like, the elephants, they were so sweet, and they were just so precious, and, you know, like, they were so loving. And when I had like that one-on-one interaction, it was special. Like, there was this one elephant, he like looked at me straight in my eyes, and we had like a little connection, kind of like weird, but it was honestly so beautiful. And so I, you know, I fed the elephants, we put mud on them, and we bathed them, and it was honestly a fun time. And then sporadically, we were like, oh, let's go ziplining. So we went ziplining too. Like, you know, it was just honestly just amazing, and it was fun too. But I'm glad I did that, because I honestly came back different, like even more different. I don't know what it is, but when you travel, like, it's like something happens to you. So if you guys are going through anything and you need some type of motivation, for me, it helped me was the traveling. Like, I need to see what's out there. I'm a free spirit. I just love everyone's culture, and the culture was just so sweet there. Everyone was so nice. Everyone said hi. Like, it was just a totally different environment from where I'm from. And I honestly loved it. So if you're interested in my little journey, just keep on watching.
It was a 14-hour flight, guys. It was kind of crazy. And we just landed.